Captain America getting political and anything but patriotic in the latest Marvel comic series released right before Independence Day.
Well, the issue claims, quote, the first American dream is the one that isn't real. It's one some people expect to just be handed to them, when the truth is it never really existed in the first place. Other cultures, immigrants, we're at our best when we keep no one out. A good dream is shared, shared radically, shared with everyone. When something isn't shared, it can become the American lie.
All right, well, you confused? So what does Superman have to say about that? Dean Cain played that role and took great pride in it. Dean, does this really bother you more than most, you would think?
Brian, you know, I am Captain America. You know, I love Captain America. I love the concept of Captain America. But I am so tired of all of this wokeness and anti-Americanism. You know, we just celebrated our 245th birthday. In my opinion, America is the greatest country in history. It's not perfect. We are constantly striving for a more perfect union, as we all know. But I believe she's the most fair, equitable country ever, with more opportunity than anyone's ever seen. And that's why people are clamoring to get here from all over the globe. I agree with Senator Tom Cotton, who was on a couple days ago, who said that perhaps Captain needs to be demoted to Lieutenant, because I think that makes good sense. We're here, you know, America has its founding principles, which I firmly believe in. I believe in individual freedom. I believe in equality of opportunity, not outcome. Competition, the ability to compete fairly, hard work, which brings you success and brings you material wealth, which in turn gives you self-reliance. That's what everybody wants on the face of this planet. That's what everybody strives for. That's why they're trying to come here. And I find, you know, this wokeness, it's pervasive. It goes through everything. It's in our school system. The cool thing to do today is bash America. The comic books do it. The schools indoctrinate our kids. They do that. Our movies, our television shows is full of it. Celebrities, actors, athletes, the media, they love to bash America. I don't get it. I wonder to myself often, do these people ever travel outside of America? Do they go to other countries where they have to deal with governments who aren't anywhere near as fair as the United States? I don't think they do. I do it all the time. And I kiss the soil when I get back here.
You're exactly right. I think more of a even more of a demotion, private first class America, whatever you want to call them. But you're right. If anybody would have traveled the globe, it's Superman and Captain America. And you remember the comic book for Superman when he disavowed his American citizenship and said he was now his allegiance was to the UN. I mean, this is everywhere. And if Captain America can't love America, then who can? And what can be done about it? Because the countercultural view now is to be patriotic. Everyone in your line of work, it's a boring take to hate the country, because that's what they're all doing.
Well, exactly. That's the whole point. Today, the cool, the fashionable thing to do is to bash America and to hate America. And I am on the exact opposite side of the fence. I love this country. I'm a full, complete optimist as well. I believe the pendulum will swing back to openly appreciating American values, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights. As soon as people start studying them in school again, I think we'll get people understanding them and appreciating them. So today, me being sort of a counterculture guy, me supporting the flag and the red, white, and blue in the United States of America makes me a revolutionary in some terms,
yes,
which I'm fine with.
Dean, thanks for coming on with us.
We're back to that.
Thanks,
being
Dean.
A revolutionary.
Thank you.
You guys look good in pink, too.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dean.
I don't.
See, Brian,
that's why I'm not.
Brian.